Birmingham, the city he found upon his arrival, was above his expectation, above all expectation. At the start of the journey, he didn't know what awaited him behind the wall. He had left Italy in a hasty and sudden manner, but now, after a year since his arrival, he was starting to get to know it better and to see it naked beneath its clothes. The city was a concentrate of things that attracted him: canals, hidden alleys, gardens and financial centers. All of it artistically blended into a multi-ethnic futuristic society. It was a pulsating city, and he was about to taste its lifeblood. He managed to almost connect with it, just only listening to the vibration of the rhythmic footstep of passersby. It was undoubtedly a great discovery for him. He too was a raw and naked kind of guy, and here he had found something waiting for him. Like in cooking, he goes straight to the point without going into empty rhetoric. He had taken a hard blow from fate, which he still carried on his legs. He tried to dodge the punch he had taken, but he needed time to regain his strength and counter them effectively. Without a doubt, good rest and strong diet was all he needed. He was welcoming the new year in the best way possible. He just needed to get back to the right vibrations, to swerve of sea in which he had already swum. Now he had a goal to reach, and therefore felt like he was halfway there. He could see the first progress coming, and that gave him confidence. After a tough start, he was starting to reap the rewards. In Tuesday, he had a renewed passion for graphics. He was using a 3D animation program that he had discovered some time ago. Even though they were light, he had made some progress. He had retained the knowledge he had learned at the first approach to this day. This was it for him, already a sort of satisfaction. Indeed, he perhaps reached them with a deeper understanding of the system language. To grasp an entirely new program, he estimated would require at least 3 years. This is the average time it takes to embark on a new learning path, like acquiring a foreign language. You may never speak like a native speaker, but with time you will still learn how to communicate with it effectively and satisfactorily. He had learned English in school, but he still could not write it correctly, and struggled to read it with the proper pronunciation. The Italian school provided him with a basic grammatical foundation, and the English street furnished him with vocabulary and phonetics. Then, time did the rest. Foreign languages were a bridge for him between two banks of a river. Once learned and mastered, they led you to a shore of land previously inaccessible. While exploring the new city, he had found some pleasant and secluded corners. Long walks along the city canals that remind him of the promenade on a warm summer beach. In the face of those who, neglecting and coveting in the shadows, offered him only the leftover of the rheatic meal. In the continuous becoming of being, the new change into the now, only to make way for a new arrival of a unknown. The experience just lived thus become vital nourishment for a new discoveries. According to him, the existence of those who had stopped only at elementary notion learned in childhood must have been meager, fearful and fragile. The reluctance to enrich one's knowledge and open up to new horizons were dictated, according to him, by the need of many to comfort their own ego from the absence of threats, of an impending leap into the void. This is a real cost that every change imposes. In short, giving up walking to avoid falling. The risk that those who embark on a new study or work path run instead. Avoiding taking a leap into the void does not circumvent the problem. Since change comes inexorably anyway, catching even the most skilled one unprepared. According to him, conflict and battles are intrinsic to life, in the struggle for survival, and withdrawing from the clash never represent an effective solution, especially if the conflict and the change occurs within ourselves.